is Joy Varghese from DVN Public School Navsari. Today we will be discussing video number 11, topic 10.6, clear, in chapter haloalkanes and haloarenes. Now in this 10.6 we are going to discuss about physical properties, in which first we are going to discuss about the color. Now when we talk about alkyl halides, are colorless when they are in pure form. The word is again clear. Alkyl halide are colorless when they are in pure form, but bromides and iodides, that is alkyl halide containing bromide and iodide, develop color when exposed to light. Means they are photoactive chemicals, what we call. Order, when we say the volatile halogen compounds, volatile means which evaporates at room temperature, have sweet smell. Now in this physical properties we are also going to discuss about melting point and boiling point. From this there are maximum question asked as MCQ also, and very short question, that is 2 marks question can also be asked based on this melting point and boiling point. Now whenever we talk about this melting point and boiling point, see, lower haloalkanes, lower alkanes means less number of carbons, what we say, methyl or ethyl when we say, they lower alkanes when we say are gases at room temperature. What is the word? Lower haloalkanes, that is methyl chloride, methyl bromide, ethyl chloride, or CFC, what we heard about chlorofluorocarbon or chlorofluoromethane, when we say they are gases at room temperature, yeah? That is the state what we call. Now this melting point and boiling point, when we discuss, the for same alkyl group, boiling point of the alkyl halide decrease in the order. Now this is what is the reason for this. We say in group 17 elements, when we call about fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, atomic size increases down the group. Now as the atomic size increases, the mass also increases. So if you see in this case, the alkyl group, this is having the highest boiling point. What is the reason for this? Because iodine is the biggest atom, what we say, and more mass of iodine. Same way when we talk about here fluorine, fluorine is what? The smallest atom, and we can say it has less mass, right? So if you see the order of boiling point of alkyl halide decreases in the order, means maximum boiling point will be of what? Alkyl iodide, and the least boiling point will be of this. That is only due to the size and the mass related to it. Now next, when we talk about boiling point of isomeric alkane means same molecular formula but different structures, when we say. So in this case, if you see, this is 1-bromobutane, 4 carbons are only there. This is also 2-bromobutane, again 4 carbon. This total carbon, if you count, also 4. And this is 2-bromo-2-methyl propane. So in this case, when you see, this is not branch. This is linear chain, what we call. So it is boiling point is 375. Here, this is little bit branch. This is at second position. So you can see 2-bromobutane boiling point 264. But when you see, this is highly branch, means as the branching increases, you will see that the boiling point decreases. Boiling point decrease with increase in branching. So for this you have to remember, boiling point is inversely proportional to branching, right? So always remember this, boiling point of isomeric alkane, when we say as the branching increases, boiling point decreases, means it is inversely proportional. Now when we talk about the next part, that is boiling point of isomeric dihalobenzene, means aromatic compounds when we talk about here, right? So para isomers are high melting point, as have higher melting point as compared to their ortho and meta isomer. It is due to the symmetry of para isomer. You can see, because of the symmetry, you can see this para isomer is having the highest boiling point. It is due to the symmetry of para isomer that fits in the crystal lattice better as compared to ortho and meta. So compared to ortho and meta, the para compounds have the higher boiling point, right? Now when we talk about the density is directly related to mass. Means what? Density increase with increase in mass of a compound. So if you see here, there are total everywhere 3 carbons are there, hydrogen also same. But if you see in this case, chlorine, bromine and iodine. Iodine is the biggest size atom, right? So what will happen in this case? The density is maximum for this compound, right? And for chlorine is the smallest atom, when we say, okay, in group 17 when we write group 17 elements, you know, groups have first is fluorine, then chlorine, bromine and iodine. Down the group, atomic size increases. So this is the biggest atomic size and mass also is the bigger, what we say. So what happens in this case? Iodine is having the highest density. Now when we talk about the solubility, this is the last topic of physical properties. Solubility. Haloalkanes are slightly soluble in water because of the formation of which one? H bond. Means solubility is due to formation of H bond. Huh? Now why the solubility is low, that we will discuss it from the textbook. Now in your textbook, if you see here in your textbook, you can see regarding this solubility topic. See here what is written. The haloalkanes are very slightly soluble in water. In order to dissolve haloalkane water, energy is required. Now this is the answer for why it is less soluble. Huh? What is the word given? In order to dissolve haloalkane water, energy is required to overcome the attraction between the haloalkane molecule and break the hydrogen bond between water molecules. Right? Less energy is released when the new attractions are set up, means bond broken and made. So, and the water molecules, as there are not as strong as the original hydrogen bond in water. Now, why is the solubility less? Because less energy is released when new attraction are set up between the haloalkane and the water molecule, and as there are not as strong as what original hydrogen bond water, as a result, the solubility of haloalkane is less in water. Water is low. So this is one question which you can ask for 2 marks. So remember this question, why solubility is low, right? Now haloalkanes tends to dissolve in organic solvents because the new intermolecular attractions, what we say, between haloalkanes and the solvent molecule have much less, have much the same strength as the one being broken in the separate haloalkanes and solvent molecule, right? But main thing what I said here, why the solubility is low in water, the reason you have to remember this thing, right? Now, this is the one you have to do it as homework for completing this or understanding this topic. That is in text question 10.6. You can see it easily. Arrange each set of compound in order of the increasing boiling point. Now, in this you can see, just write down the structure, right? Properly formula you write down, so you will come to know. Now in this case I will give you just a hint. This is bromo methane. Bromo form means what? You can write CHBr3, right? Now here 3 bromine and here bromo methane means CH3Br, only one bromine. In this case chloromethane, so it is CH3Cl, right? And this is dibromo methane. Dibromo means BrCH2 and here Br. Right? So in this all the case you always have to remember regarding the mass. Now this you can go through it, and this answers I will be giving in the next video, that is video 12. Now the next topic after this what we are going to discuss is about chemical reaction. This is the last topic of our chapter, but it is the lengthiest topic. 10.7 chemical reaction, in which the haloalkanes may be divided into following categories: nucleophiles, substitution reaction, elimination reaction and reaction with metal. The first we are going to discuss and in the next video is nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, thank you.